Happy Tuesday, Nomadic Dan bouncing around Indianapolis today. Today I think, I needed a reminder. I needed a reminder of somebody to look up to. And so we have, Can I Play the Piano Anymore? Obstacles Overcome. UNT composition student finishes degree despite setbacks after car wreck. By Jenna Duncan. The Denton Record-Chronicle. Saturday, May 11th, 2019. In high school, Mason Bynes and her friends let their peers by singing Valentines. For those of you that don't have fun friends, singing Valentines are Valentines where people sing to someone on your behalf. She would go the extra step and make the songs into mashups and arrange them, then perform them for her peers. Pitch Perfect. That's how she knew she wanted to be a composer. Page turn. I like collaboration. I like meeting people and different types of music and people that listen to those different types of music. Then trying to get what they all like into that music and that art, she said. That's what started this whole thing. Bynes graduated during the UNT College of Music ceremony Friday afternoon, one of seven commencement ceremonies that took part in town. Ceremonies at UNT and Texas Women's University will continue on Saturday. Her path to graduation was unusual. A life-changing car wreck during Christmas break her freshman year left her without the pointer and middle fingers on her left hand. I got to the hospital and the first thing I told them was I was a musician and I needed my fingers, and they said they'd try their best, but it looked like they wouldn't be able to save them, she said. So I had to sign away the right to do so. It was devastating. After, she didn't want to go back to school. Nerve damage meant even her remaining fingers couldn't work and she could barely lift her hand. Her parents strong-armed her into going back, and she adjusted her schedule to take a semester off of piano. Strong-arm. Nice. Composition majors are required to take four levels of piano courses, then pass a proficiency exam to qualify for graduation. With the test looming and her peers advancing, Bynes focused on physical therapy and trying to relearn her songs without being able to extend those two fingers. After physical therapy, I would go home and try and play my songs again, she said, and it was the most emotional, painful thing I could do physically and emotionally. A lot of the songs I was saving for when I would make it, and I felt like that time was gone. It was hard to come to terms with. It took two more years before she would finally get insurance approval for two prosthetic fingers, bright purple and weighted enough to play keys. With the new finger, she had to retrain her body again to reach proficiency. While she was a semester behind her peers, Bynes was able to take and pass the piano proficiency test, clearing the way for the graduation. Now she's headed to Boston in the fall to start a master's degree in composition at Berklee College of Music with the goal of writing scores for film. I think it's important just to say I feel bigger than this and I feel like I have more to offer than just my story, she said. I think that's what's awesome about being a composer is that you're a lot of different things. You're a storyteller, a collaborator, a musician, and a performer. I'm a lot of different things. Just looking forward, it's from hearing her story, it's it seems like she's going places, and it's very interesting to see. It would be very interesting to see when people don't even talk about what she's overcome right here. Just that, you know, she's an amazing composer, you know, what have you. Amazing whatever she's doing in her job. I don't know. The only takeaway I can really think of is, are you brave enough to reach for your dreams? I don't know. If you're not brave enough, are you at least crazy enough? This has been Dan. And just remember that your news doesn't have to make you sad if you listen to news that doesn't suck.